Starship Super Handy Test Campaign. NASA's Artemis 2 Progress. Yesterday's Starlink Launch. ISRO New Target for Moon Landing.
Hello everyone, welcome back. Here is our new episode with latest SpaceX and space news. So, let's get started.
Well, today we have a lot to discuss about the recent test campaign conducted by SpaceX on Ship 25 and Booster 9. You know, the interesting times are back again. SpaceX's recent tests involve the complex process of stacking and attacking Ship 25 and Booster 9, which has occurred up to 4 times. These tests serve as critical steps in preparing for a full stack test. Although they didn't immediately proceed to a wet dress rehearsal, WDR, they did undergo multiple rounds of testing. During the series of tests, some fascinating events took place. First, the liquid oxygen subcooler emitted white smoke, showcasing the challenges of working with extremely cold temperatures in the range of minus 60 to minus 20 degrees Celsius, around minus 260 to minus 330 degrees Fahrenheit. The thin steel tanks, containing cryogenic liquids like liquid oxygen and liquid methane, rapidly chill when filled due to their lack of insulation. This causes them to freeze water vapor from the humid South Texas air, resulting in a layer of frost and ice. As the supercooled steel tanks come into contact with the warmer surroundings, the cryogenic liquids boil off into gas. To manage pressure, rockets occasionally vent off this gas, and this process is a crucial part of the tests. In addition to testing Ship 25 and Booster 9, SpaceX successfully activated and tested the water deluge system. This system is responsible for ejecting a massive amount of water in less than 60 seconds. The increased duration of this water ejection is due to the addition of more water storage and high-pressure gas capacity. The system now holds nearly double the amount of high-pressure gas compared to previous tests. It's important to note that this water is used to cool the launch pad and divert the force of the rocket's engines away from concrete and steel structures. SpaceX takes environmental responsibility seriously. The massive amount of water used in the launch site is essential to protect the ecosystem surrounding the pad. While the water turns into steam during launches, there are concerns about the impact of excessive water flow on the surrounding wildlife. Balancing the needs of rocket launches with environmental concerns is an ongoing challenge. The fully stacked ship booster pair of 25-9 stands at an impressive 122 meters tall. This makes it the largest rocket ever assembled, surpassing the Falcon 9 and Heavy rockets currently operated by SpaceX. Starship, as a fully reusable spacecraft, aims to dramatically reduce launch costs. If all goes as planned, it could be up to 10 times cheaper to launch than the Falcon rockets while carrying significantly more payload. This has the potential to revolutionize access to space. However, SpaceX is currently facing regulatory hurdles. To launch Ship 25 and Booster 9, they need a launch license from the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, which is the primary regulator for commercial space transport in the U.S. The FAA is still reviewing data and environmental impacts from Starship's first flight test in April, which ended in an explosion due to engine failures. In 2021, NASA selected SpaceX to develop a moon lander version of Starship for the Artemis 3 mission, set for late 2025. This mission aims to transport American astronauts between lunar orbit and the lunar surface. SpaceX's contract with NASA requires them to use Starship to land American astronauts on the moon ahead of other nations. Bill Gerstenmaier, SpaceX's Vice President of Build and Flight Reliability, emphasized the need for early test flights to prove the critical systems for landing NASA astronauts on the lunar surface. Despite challenges and regulatory delays, SpaceX is dedicated to innovation and maintaining the U.S.'s leadership in space exploration. Now, let's discuss some updates about NASA's Artemis 2 and SLS rocket progress. The core stage of NASA's powerful space launch system, SLS, rocket, which is slated to carry the 4 astronaut crew of Artemis 2 around the moon in November 2024, is currently under assembly at NASA's Michoud Assembly Facility in New Orleans. However, a recent report suggests that there are welding issues with the core stage for Artemis 3, another key mission. Despite this hiccup, there are no expected delays for either launch due to this problem. Artemis 2 is a significant mission as it will carry astronauts around the moon, rekindling human lunar exploration. Meanwhile, Artemis 3 plays a crucial role in landing astronauts on the lunar surface. Both missions are integral to NASA's ambitious lunar program, but it appears that Artemis 3's core stage is currently facing welding issues. NASA has not publicly discussed the welding issue in its recent blog update about Artemis 2's core stage. However, Boeing, a key player in the SLS project, clarified that the issue is not affecting the core stage for Artemis 2 and is being addressed for Artemis 3. This suggests that while there may be a challenge, NASA and its partners are actively working to resolve it and keep both missions on schedule. NASA Spaceflight reported that the welding problem on Artemis 3 is actively being worked on, and NASA officials are hopeful that the core stage will be completed on time. While the specifics of the welding issues are not detailed, it's clear that NASA is actively engaged in addressing the problem. The welding issues seem to revolve around the SLS liquid oxygen tank's aft dome and have been ongoing for several months. The report did not provide specific details about the nature of the welding problems. However, it's a complex technical challenge that NASA, Boeing, and their partners are working to resolve. NASA officials later clarified that the non-conformance issue on Artemis 3 was identified during routine quality assurance checks and is currently being resolved. They emphasized that the rocket remains on track to support the Artemis 3 launch. The same assurance applies to Artemis 2, demonstrating NASA's commitment to overcoming production challenges and sticking to their ambitious lunar exploration schedule. SpaceX continues to expand its Starlink internet constellation with another successful launch of 23 Starlink satellites. The Falcon 9 rocket took off from Florida's Cape Canaveral Space Force Station on the company's second mission of the day, demonstrating their commitment to enhancing global internet access. The launch occurred on the evening of October 21st, with liftoff at 10:17 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. The Falcon 9's first stage, which was on its fourth flight, made an impressive vertical landing about 8.5 minutes after launch. It touched down safely on the drone ship named a Shortfall Gravitas, positioned in the Atlantic Ocean. Approximately 65.5 minutes after launch, the 23 Starlink satellites were scheduled to deploy from the Falcon 9's upper stage. These satellites are crucial components of SpaceX's Starlink mega constellation, which aims to provide internet service to customers across the globe. Starlink is SpaceX's ambitious project to create a mega constellation of satellites in low Earth orbit. These satellites work together to provide internet access to customers, even in remote and underserved areas. With almost 4,900 operational Starlink satellites already in orbit, the constellation is continually growing to reach more people in need of reliable internet access. The Indian government announced plans to put astronauts on the moon by 2040 and construct an Indian space station by 2035. These announcements follow a high-level meeting chaired by India's Prime Minister, Narendra Modi, to assess the progress of the Gaganyaan human spaceflight mission. The Indian government statement reveals a bold vision for the nation's space program. It includes plans to establish the Bharatiya Antariksh Station, Indian Space Station, by 2035 and send the first Indian astronaut to the moon by 2040. These goals signify a significant leap forward in India's space exploration initiatives. India's space journey has been marked by important milestones, with a focus on independent human spaceflight capabilities. The country aims to achieve its first crewed flight as part of the Gaganyaan mission in 2025. This mission is set to demonstrate India's capability to send astronauts into space, a significant achievement in itself.
So that's all about today's episode. See you tomorrow, and until then, goodbye.